Welcome to Alanis Business Academy. I'm Matt Alanis, and this is How the VIX Works. Now, due to recent market volatility, I thought it'd be helpful to cover a commonly used measure for gauging future expected market volatility. This measure is known as the Chicago Board Options Exchange Volatility Index, commonly referred to simply by its ticker symbol VIX or VIX. So how does the VIX work? Commonly referred to as the investor's fear gauge, the VIX is constructed using implied volatilities of a wide range of S&P 500 options. As a way of producing a numerical value, the VIX uses a mathematical formula to analyze the difference between prices for call options in comparison to put options. Now, a call option is a type of option contract that gives the owner the right to purchase a specified number of a certain security at a set price for an established period of time. Although the owner of the contract may exercise their call option if they wish, they're under no obligation to do so. So here's how it works. Let's say that you purchase a call option to purchase 100 shares of XYZ Company at $100 per share over the next 7 days. XYZ Company is currently trading at $95 per share. If you exercised your call option now, you would be purchasing shares of XYZ Company for $100 a piece while their market value is $95 a piece. So essentially, you're losing $5 per share or $500 total if you purchase 100 shares. So unless its share price increases over $100, there is no reason for you to exercise your call option. But if XYZ Company appreciates to, let's say, $105 per share, you can exercise your call option and purchase shares for $100 each. You can then turn around and immediately sell them for $105 per share, which is the market value, or you can simply put them in your portfolio. Selling the securities immediately would yield you a $5 per share profit or $500 total, assuming all 100 shares are purchased. Now, the only reason that an investor would buy a call option is if they felt that the market was going to appreciate in value. As a result, a greater number of call options compared to put options will lower the numerical value of the VIX. Now, a put option is another type of options contract that works in a very similar fashion to a call. However, instead of having the option to purchase a security, a put provides the owner with the right to sell a specified number of shares at a specific price within a certain period of time. Think of a put option as like insurance on your home or vehicle. Just like homeowners insurance and auto insurance, a put option is meant to protect you in the case that your asset becomes damaged or in this case decreases in value significantly. If that does happen, you have a contract that gives you the right to sell at a higher than market value. For example, let's say that you purchase a put option allowing you to acquire 100 shares of XYZ Company at $100 per share for a 7-day period. All of a sudden, the share price of XYZ Company plummets from $105 to $90 per share. Because you are the owner of a put option, you can exercise your option and sell your shares at $100 per share instead of the market value of $90 per share, which would save you quite a bit of money. Now, the only reason that an investor would purchase a put option is if they expected a security to decrease in value and they either wanted to protect their own investments or take advantage of investors who were not as vigilant. Take into account the basic economic principle of supply and demand, if investors purchase a larger number of call options, then the premiums or prices of these options will increase, which will result in a lower VIX. If investors purchase a larger number of put options, then the premiums for those options will increase, which will result in a higher VIX. Although meaningless to some, this numerical value carries significant importance to investors. A score greater than 30 communicates a greater amount of volatility is expected going forward and that investors are overall more fearful. A score of less than 20 communicates the expectation of low risk and low market volatility in the future, at least the expectation. Due to the fact that the VIX is evaluating calls and puts that are purchased based upon assumptions as well as expectations, the index measures the expectation of volatility and not actual volatility itself. So as with any measure, there is always a risk in relying solely on one indicator to make an investment decision. This has been How the VIX Works. For access to additional videos, be sure to subscribe to Alanis Business Academy, and also remember to like and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.